Consider a program that has a number of methods. Suppose the program is executed by calling method main. Method main ends up calling method first, and then first calls method second. Now suppose that an object A0 is thrown, signaling some sort of error, and suppose that no try statements are being executed. Since there is no catch clause to catch the object, it is thrown further to the calling method. Thus, in this example, it appears that the call on method second throws A0. And if this call on method second does not appear within a try block, object A0 is thrown out further to calling method main. So it looks like the method call throws A0. This call on first is within a try block, so if one of its catch clauses catches A0, that's the end of the throwing. But suppose that the catch blocks of a try statement do not catch the object. Then it is thrown outside the try statement so that it looks like the try statement throws the object. In our example, the try statement is not in a try block, so rule 1 is used. Object A0 is thrown to the caller of method main, which is within the Java system itself. The call of method main within the system is within the try block of a try statement that catches all throwable objects. So the catch block is guaranteed to print the information about the thrown object.